بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. قال مصنف رحمه الله تعالى ابن هجر الأسقلاني في كتابه بلوغ المرام في كتاب الصيام عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسحروا فإن في السحور بركة. متفق عليه. أبين أن نعم الله سبحانه وتعالى أنسن peace and blessings, salutations upon the best of the Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Abd al-Muttalib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and upon his family and his companions. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we will be reading from the book, the famous book by the scholar Ibn Hajar in his book, his famous book of hadith, Bulugh al-Maram, in the chapter of fasting. He narrates from Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, eat the pre-fasting meal, for in it is blessings. This hadith has been reported by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala wa Imam Muslim rahimahullah ta'ala. And we will be reading inshallah ta'ala from the explanation of the scholar Abdullah ibn Abd al-Rahman al-Bassam rahimahullah ta'ala, who was from the kibar ulama in Saudiya, and his book Tawdih Al-Ahkam in Bulugh al-Maram. The Shaykh said rahimahullah ta'ala that the word as-suhur with a fatha over the scene, for all of you students of the lugha, for all of you students of the Arabic language, he said that the word suhoor, it comes in two ways. One, it comes with a fatha over the seen, as-suhoor. And it is the food that is eaten before one fast. And it also comes in the language as-suhoor, with the dhamma. And both of these words, whether it's with a fatha or dhamma, it comes from the asl of the word as-sahar. And this refers to the time right before fajr. يعني وهو ما قبيل الفجر. As-sahara is right before salat al-fajr. So this word suhoor comes from the time. And we know, and we'll talk about later inshallah, that this is a blessed time. Also, the word barakah. In the Arabic language, the word barakah, it means katharatil khayr. Katharatil khayr. It means something that has lots of good in it. And from its meanings, min ma'aniha an-nima والزيادة. النماء والزيادة. And it means also linguistically, the word baraka means to increase or augment. And as you know, when you make dua for somebody, you make dua that they have baraka. يعني تبريك. It is dua بالبركة. So when you say to someone, بارك الله فيك, يعني you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put كثرت الخير in one's life, in his actions, in his wealth, in his health. يعني that Allah increase one in goodness. شيخ عبد الله البسام رحمه الله تعالى, he also brings another hadith by Imam Ahmed. He said, زاد إمام أحمد رحمه الله تعالى من حديث أبي سعيد رضي الله عنه قال, فلا تدعوه ولو أن يتجرع أحدكم جرعة من ماء, إن الله والملائكة يصلون على المتسحرين. And he brought a hadith by Imam Ahmed, who reported from the noble Sahabi, the noble companion, Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do not leave it, do not leave off the suhoor. فَلَا تَدْعُوهُ وَلَوْ أَنْ يَتَجَرَّعَ أَحَدَكُمْ جَرْعَةٍ مِنْ مَا. Do not leave off the suhoor, even if one was to take a sip or a gulp of water. For verily, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ وَالْمَلَائِكَتُهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى الْمُتَسَحِّرِينَ. For verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the angels, they send salutations upon those that partake in the pre-fasting meal. SubhanAllah. He said from the benefits of this hadith, يعني الظاهر حديث وجوب السهور. He said, from the apparent meaning of this hadith, يعني تسحروا فلا تدعوه, it seems like it would be obligatory upon the Muslim to have the pre-dawn meal. But there's another hadith that makes this action of partaking in the pre-dawn meal a suhoor, or a suhoor bil-fatah or dhamma. There's another hadith that takes it from being obligatory to something that is recommended in the religion. And this hadith, which has been authenticated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam at times, يعني هو كان يتواصل, يتواصل, يعني he would continuously fast. So because of this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam wouldn't take suhoor. So the famous scholar, وقد نقل ابن منذر الإجماع على أن التسحور مندوب وليس واجب. The famous scholar, رحمه الله تعالى, ابن منذور, he narrated that it is a consensus of the scholars that suhoor is something that is highly recommended, not obligatory. And we know in the Sharia, something that is recommended is defined as something that you get a reward for if you do it. And if you leave it, la ba's, there's no sin upon you. Where wajib, something that's wajib, is the opposite. It's something that the Sharia, it commands, and the one that does it, he gets a reward, and the one that leaves it, he's athim, he's sinful. So we know from this that suhoor is something that is recommended. The third point that he mentions is barakah, al-barakatul hasila min al-suhoor ma fihi min imtithal al-amr al-shar'i فطاعات الله تعالى هي امتثال الأمر واجتناب النهي. He said that the blessing comes about from suhoor in doing that which the Sharia commands, in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also leaving off what he has commanded. Okay, so basically, there's blessings when you do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded or recommended the servant to do. Whenever we do that, that's barakah, that's khayr kathir. Even though we know that this hadith is not, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't command the Muslims to eat suhoor from the point of view that it is obligatory. We understand that. But at the same time, the one that does it, he gets a blessing. This is a blessing in it, in itself, because this is what the Sharia has commanded. And he said also, وَمِن بَرَكَاتِهِ إلى الأكل للتقوي على الصيام وطاعة الله تعالى وعبادته. And he said that eating the suhoor, it strengthens one, gives strength to the one that will partake in the fast, and also it gives strength and obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his worship. So this gives strength to the one that wants to obey Allah, and also gives strength in the servant's worship. And he also said that وَمِنْ بَرَكَاتِهِ إِنَّ السُّهُورِ يُعْتِي صَائِمْ قُوَّةٍ لَا يُمِلُّ مَعَهَا الصِّيَامِ. And the suhoor, it gives the Muslim strength. So that he doesn't become overtaken by the fast, as opposed to the one that doesn't partake with the suhoor. So the one that doesn't have suhoor, you find that the fast becomes difficult for him, and also other acts of ibadah becomes difficult. Why? Because he didn't take the suhoor. And I'm sure some of us know the difference in our worship when we miss the suhoor meal. It's a big difference in the days that we have suhoor and the days that we don't. And he said, وَمِنْ بَرَكَةِ السُّهُورِ إِنَّهُ يَكُونُ سَبَبًا لِإِنْتِبَائِهِ مِنَ النَّوْمِ فِي وَقْتِ السَّحَرِ الَّذِي هُوَ وَقْتُ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ وَالدُّعَاءِ وفيه ينزل رب جل وعلا إلى السماء الدنيا ينادي عباده ليسأله مطالبهم ورغباتهم. And the Shaykh, he said, رحمه الله تعالى, that السهور, it makes one keen to wake up during the time of سهور, which is the time of استغفار والدعاء. So this time, يعني قبيل صلاة الفجر, this time, right before Fajr, is a blessed time. Why? Because this is the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends from the sama. And you know, from the belief of Ahlul Sunnah, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ينزل إلى السماء الدنيا, that Allah comes down to the lowest heavens in a way that befits His majesty. We don't cave. You know, ask how. You know, we affirm that which comes in the authentic text. This is what the Salafi is upon. So this time of suhoor is a time of istighfar wa du'a. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa yunadi, He calls out to His servants, those that call upon Him for their needs. This is the time the servants call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their needs and desires. Because this time is Mubarak. This is the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the dua. And he said, وَمِنْ بَرَكَةِ السُّهُورِ صَلَاةُ الْفَجْرِ مَعَ جِمَعَةِ وَفِي وَقْتِهَا الْفَاضِلِ وَلِذَا تَجِدْ الْمُصَلِّينَ فِي صَلَاةِ الْفَجْرِ فِي رَمَضَانَ أَكْثَرُ مِنْهُمْ في غيره من الشهور لأنهم قاموا من أجل سهور. And he said another blessing of the suhoor is that this makes one pray Salatul Fajr in congregation. And he went on to say that this is why in Ramadan you see more Muslims in the masjid for Salatul Fajr than any other time of the year. Why? Because the Muslim gets up for suhoor. And this makes him pray Fajr in the congregation. And the fourth point, Sheikh says, يَنْبَغِي لِلْمُسْلِمْ أَلَّا يَقُومَ بِأُمُورِهِ الْعَادِيَّةِ مُجَرِّدَةٍ عَنِ النِّيَّةِ صَالِحَةً. He said that it is upon the Muslim that he desires to make his actions, his normal actions, have his day-to-day actions have a good intention. So the Muslim, what he does is his daily actions, he makes them into acts of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلْ يُمُرِنَّ نَفْسُهُ عَلَىٰ أَن تَكُونَ عَمَالُهُ عَادِيَةً عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. And what the servant does is that he makes his intentions, whether it's eating or dressing, whatever he does, he makes his intentions for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all of his actions, subhanAllah, becomes acts of worship. So here we know that eating, the suhoor, is niyyah. It goes from just eating a regular meal to one that he gets ajr for, subhanAllah, because he's doing this for the fast. The next point that the Shaykh mentions, the suhoor, من مخالفات أهل الكتاب فقد جاء في صحيح مسلم من حديث عبد الله بن عمر قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الفصل ما بين صيامنا وصيام أهل الكتاب أكلة السهور. And this is a good point. The Sheikh mentions that the suhoor is going against how the Jews and the Christians fast. The suhoor, it goes against how the Jews and the Christians fast. And the Sharia has commanded us to be different from them. And he mentions the hadith of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, who said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and this hadith is mentioned in Sahih Muslim, إِنَّ الْفَصْلَ مَا بَيْنَ صِيَامِنَا وَصِيَامِ الْأَحْلِ كِتَابِ. He said, verily, the difference between our fasting and the fasting of the Jews and the Christians is the partaking or the eating of the pre-fast meal. This is the difference between us and them. And he said, "الشارِع يريد أن لا يكون لنا مشابهة بالكفار لا في العبادات ولا في العادات." And he said that the Sharia, it commands us that we don't resemble the kuffar, not in actions of worship and not in everyday actions. لكن إن تشبه المسلم بالكفار بعباداتهم فهذا قد يؤدي إلى شرك والكفر. And he said, however, in addition, that when a Muslim imitates the kuffar in their worship, this can lead to one making partners for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in disbelief. So imitating the kuffar in acts of worship, it can lead to associating partners with Allah, and we know that this is the greatest sin that the human can do. And also it leads to other forms of disbelief. وَإِنْ كَانَ فِي الْعَادَاتِ بِاسْتِحْسَانِ إِفْعَالِهِمْ وَعَادَاتِهِمْ وَهَذَا قَدْ يَعُولُ إِلَى تُشَبِّهِ بِهِمْ فِي الْأُمُورِ بَاطِنَا وَيَكُونَ مِنْهُ حَلَاكٍ. And imitating them in actions of, in everyday actions, the way we dress, our mannerisms, imitating them in this, and just in everyday actions, at that, normal everyday actions, this could lead to one being affected internally. One can be affected internally by following them and imitating them in their daily interactions. And thus one will become destroyed. And the sixth point that he mentions, رحمه الله تعالى, قوله فإن في السهور بركة. The sixth point that he mentions that in this part of the hadith, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, فإن سهور, there's a blessing in the سهور, in the partaking, in the pre-fasting meal. This is proof, دليل على أن بركة تكون في مخلوقات.
This is proof that barakah, that blessing, can be found in creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from this we know that suhoor is barakah in it. So some things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, He has put barakah in. وَذَٰلِكَ بِحَسْبِ مَا وَهَبَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مِنْ قُدْرَتِهِ وَالْمُؤَحَّلَاتِ وَمَنْفَعَةِ وَقَدْ يَكُونُ فِي الْإِنسَانِ بَرَكَةٌ. And he said, وَبِذَٰلِكَ بِحَسْبِ مَا وَهَبَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مِنْ قُدْرَةِ وَمُؤَحَّلَاتِ وَمَنْفَعَةِ. And this is depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowing benefit in a particular thing. And also, فَقَدْ يَكُونَ فِي الْإِنسَانِ بَرَكَةٌ. And possibly you can find barakah in a person. إِمَّا بِعِلْمِهِ وَإِمَّا بِبَدْنِهِ وَإِمَّا بِخَلْقِهِ وَإِمَّا بِمَالِهِ وَإِمَّا بِجَاهِهِ. Perhaps a person could be blessed with his knowledge and his body and his wealth and his position or his esteem that he might have. فَيَحْصُلْ مِنْهُ خَيْرٌ يَنْتَفَعُ بِهِ غَيْرِ. And he benefits others with his goodness. So it's possible. So this hadith is proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put barakah in his creation. Now I'd like to add that this is not understood in the way that the Sufiya or the Rawafid, the Shia, they understand barakah. Only the Sharia can determine what has barakah in it. Only the Sharia. What comes in Kitab Allah or the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we know that a time, from this hadith, we know that a time is blessed. مَا قُبَيْ صَلَاةُ الْفَجْرِ. Why? Because this is the waqt of istighfar wa dua. How do we know this? Because it comes in the Kitab or Sunnah. The Kitab or Sunnah. It comes in that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is hadith. Hadith, also suhoor, a place can be blessed. Mecca, Medina, Al-Quds, Majalis Ahl al-Ilm, Majalis al-Dhikr, Ta'am. This is not understood to mean that we can make, follow our desires and make something blessed that there's no delir for, like the Shia and the Sufiya. Where they make the imams and the shuyukh, and they worship them to the point where they think they have blessings in them. They worship their graves and the likes. So the sharia is what defines what is blessed, and we don't exceed the boundaries in that. And this is where the people go to extremes in worshiping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Leads to grave worship. And the Shaykh, he goes on to say, وَمَمْنُعْ مِنْ تَبَرُّكْ فِي مَخْلُوقِينَ إِنْ تَكُونَ بِجِسْمِهِ فَتَبَرُّكْ بِالظَّاهِرِ مِنْ فَضَلَاتِهِ وَثِيَابِهِ وَشُعُورِهِ وَنَهْوِ. He said, and it is prohibited in the religion to seek blessings in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in one's body. So again, you go back to the Sufiya. They might go up to one of the sheikhs and wipe their hands on him. This is a form of associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is shirk. or they might grab his clothes or take pieces of his hair from his body, from his beard or from his head, and they hold it and they think this is khayr in it. La. Why? Because this is not what the Sharia said for us to do. So they go to ghulu, they go to extremes and worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a bab which leads to shirk billah. وَعَيَّعْذِ بِاللَّهِ. And also you see, for example, those of you that have made Hajj Umrah, you see that many of the ignorant people, they go around the Kaaba and they wipe, for example, the footprints of Ibrahim alayhi salam. They wipe parts of the Haram or parts of the Kaaba that there's no delay for because they think there's barakah in it. La. The Sharia defines for us what has barakah and what doesn't. Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ajma'in. Well, a benefit from this hadith also, the Shaykh says, a hadith al-amr wa tasahhur wa haddi alay wa ta'khirihi wa ta'ajil fitra mutawatira hakahu al-tahawi rahimahullah wa ghayruhu. ولا يجب صهور حكاه ابن منذر وغيره إجماع. And another benefit from this noble hadith is that the command for صهور and its encouragement is that it's delayed. So the صهور is actually delayed closer to Salat al-Fitr, closer to the Salat al-Fajr. And the fitr, futur, is actually hasten to. So you hasten to have your iftar. And this goes against the way of the Shia and the Rawafid, because they delay their suhoor in the Maghrib until the stars come out. But Ahlul Sunnah, from the ulama, they say this is a tahawi, and Ibn Munzir is that this is a consensus of the scholars, that the suhoor is delayed closer to Fajr, and the iftar is hastened. As soon as you hear the adhan for Salatul Maghrib, then you break your fast. وَقَالَ Ibn Abdul Barr رحمه الله تعالى أحاديث تعجيل فطور وتأخير صهور صحيحة متواترة. The famous scholar Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that the hadith that talk about the hastening of the futur and the delaying of the suhoor are authentic and they're متواترة, يعني they've reached a level that there's no doubt that these they've been related by so many sahaba that there's no doubt that these hadith are sahih. Allahu alam, Allahu